Hey, welcome back. So this is the continuation of putting an inner rotor kit on a scooter, motorcycle, moped, whatever, two-stroke. Today we're going to be kind of talking about setting it with a timing light once you've initially set it up to the millimeter mark. So one thing I noticed I kind of glossed over on the last video was I said, oh yes, and while you have the piston set at top dead center, so when your mark is like over here or whatever, and you know where top dead center is, I was adjusting this ring to the 0 point, just so that I know that that's top dead center on the paper ring as well. You'll need that for later if you're going to actually use the timing gun and you want the numbers to actually mean something. The other thing I didn't mention is on this, and also on the Malossi unit, I believe as well, there are arrows showing direction. So whenever you set it up, whatever way your motor runs, you need to set it to that line. If you set it to the other one, it's probably not gonna run for you. Something else I just kind of noticed as I was rewatching it. But let's jump into this. So most ignitions that you get for scooters aren't adjustable in the sense that they're usually a flat curve. For example, Honda Dios, they're flat set at 17 degrees, but it is something to be aware of. So again, following this with a straight line curve CDI box is probably going to net you with nothing but heartache. So just be aware of that if you don't have one that has a programmed curve in it. Don't follow this blindly. And also, you should know how much your curve goes, because some boxes are more aggressive than others. It's not really hard to tell. You can, if you have a degree wheel, you start the bike up, you check where it is, you rev the bike all the way out, you check where it goes to, you kind of have an idea of how much advance you have initially. So you can kind of scale that around to where you want it to be, which is why the timing light becomes much more useful in that sense, that you can actually move stuff in degree increments up or down or wherever you want and see if that nets you, you know, better drivability, more power, cooler temperatures, etc., etc., whatever you're looking for. I brought a couple of simple curves. So this is off of a PVL ignition programmable. This is a Minarelli curve that they had on their website. This, as you can see, starts out in the 1 to 2,000 RPM range, which is around where you're going to have like your idle slash startup. It's actually pretty low and then spikes all the way up to 30 degrees. Now, the reason for that, I'm guessing, is because if you have it up high in the 30, 35 degree range, you can experience kickbacks, and then even higher than that, you can actually have the thing probably start backwards, where the piston doesn't have enough piston speed to come up and complete the travel, and the combustion pushes it back down, and then the bike will run backwards. So that little bit of the curve there is usually a sign of just to help the thing get started in the right direction, and then it goes to the full advance. So on this map, you can see it hits about 6 grand, and then they just taper it off to about, looks like 7 or 8 degrees. Next up, we have this, I believe this is an RS125 map, a few different ones shown here. This map here, which seems to have like an easy start, it cropped it off, but this is about 30 degrees. And you can see similar, this one, it carries it for quite a bit longer up till about 8K, and then it tapers it off and it ends at about 12.5. This is also a Honda RS125, standard ignition, pretty much just slightly under 25 degrees the whole way, and then falls off at about 8K and carries off to about 14K. And you notice that it says power band area, and that's right in around this probably 15 degrees here. And then they have another one that bumps the map up to 29-ish degrees. And these are all just, I mean, this just kind of is showing you more than anything just what a typical two-stroke map looks like. These aren't hard and fast rules of anything. I mean, they kind of are, but in the sense that those can move around. I was looking on some of the Aprilia forums, and the guys have like 35 plus degrees of advance in like initially. That probably is for reasons, but every setup is going to be different. What I'm going to try and replicate is going to get the timing set to about as close to 30 degrees at baseline, 28 to 30 degrees at like 1 to 2K kind of thing, and we'll go from there. So for kit for this, I have a Mega El Cheapo timing light. There's no circuitry in this, there's nothing fancy. And the reason why I have this one is I do have another one. I have this nice Innova, which works good on four-stroke stuff, but every time I've tried to put it onto a two-stroke, I've found that it won't work, and I've tried resistor plugs and non, and it just seems to give me really, really erratic readings. I think that has something to do with just some RF interference or something. It's just not happy when I try using it. So this guy is my go-to, and it works great. The next part's going to be quite loud and noisy, but I'll probably just subtitle it. So I'm just going to warm this up and get going. Typical problem I've encountered with both my timing lights is that we lose signal over 10,000 RPM. I think just the circuitry inside can't keep up. But you can see that it definitely has a curve and it is dropping. It's approximately at 30 at idle and drops down to 10 before I can't see it anymore. So I'm going to adjust that a little bit. I'm going to actually take a little bit of advance out of it. I'd like to see it around 28-ish, just because I don't have any control over the initial curve. And I want to make sure that I have the safety net down low. It's not too far advanced for too long at peak RPM. So once you have it set, because you've turned all this, your top dead center mark is going to move. So you're going to have to also refined top dead center and adjust your timing wheel accordingly if you want the numbers to make sense. And just to find defined top dead center again, just throw your piston stop in. So this side went to 10, this side went to 20. So I needed to take half of that from this side and shift it over, moved it 15 degrees. So that means that even though the mark's not pointing at it, where that zero point is should be about top dead center for me. So there we go. That's generally how you set up your timing with the timing light. Very useful to just confirm what you've done is actually working and to make sure that you're adjusting it the right way, because you can mess some stuff up pretty quick if you put too much timing into something. But I think that pretty much covers it. Until next time, take care.